And it has a very hollow structure. And in the wall structure, you could see the hexagon structures or hexagon patterns there. And normally, we could transform from the 1D graphene sheet into 2D single nanotube if you could load them over. Depending on the rolling orientation, so you may got a graphene sheet like this. You can roll it in the horizontal direction. That will form a zigzag carbon nanotube. You can actually roll it in the vertical direction. That will form an armchair carbon nanotube. Or you can actually roll it over in diagonally to form a chiral structure carbon nanotube. So depending on orientation and how you roll up the carbon nanotube, you may end up with different patterns for the carbon nanotube structures. Classification of carbon nanotube. We classify carbon nanotube either as a single walled carbon nanotube, if they only got a single layers of the graphene to be rolled up, or can be multi-walled carbon nanotube, which consists two or three or four multi-layer structures. And these multi-walled carbon nanotube, the intralayers, normally we have very weak wendable interactions to keep them together. Okay, so you keep all these structures together through very weak vulnerable interactions. Application for CNT. Since the discovery of the CNT by Dr. Ijima in 1991, people have used the carbon nanotube quite a lot to enhance the mechanical properties, because in nature, the carbon-carbon bond is the strongest bond. Okay, it's the strongest bond. Therefore, anything you could use the carbon-carbon bond materials will give you the fantastic mechanical properties. Also, carbon nanotube has been used as the light, low-mass materials in the aerospace industry, because you could see that carbon nanotube is hollow and it's a hexagon pattern, so it's relatively light, especially when you mix only small amount into some of the polymers or materials, and you could significantly enhance the properties. So they have light, low mass feature there. And finally, because the carbon-carbon bond, we can achieve very high thermal electrical conductivities if you use the carbon nanotube as a transistor or as the nanowires for some of the fabrication process. As I mentioned, sometimes we cannot only use the nanomaterial itself. We have to mix it with other materials. Mm-hmm. For example, to use the carbon nanotube, you have to mix the carbon nanotubes with some of the polymers, okay? In order to enhance the mechanical properties, the carbon nanotubes have to be well dispersed into the continuous polymers. And in order to form the CNT composite, we call carbon nanotube composite, polymer composites. And some of the real examples I'd like to show you is we use the CNT composites to make the tennis racket, or even we used it for making the baseball bats. Okay, so you could see very, very small amount. Normally less than 3 to 5% by weight of the whole composite materials. And also Nissan start to use the CNT to fabricate the car bumper. Okay, because small amount of CNT you actually disperse into some polypropylene or polyolefin kind of polymer materials, you could actually get quite good impact absorption for the bumper part. And also NASA is quite interested in this wind murfing technology by using carbon nanotube. So you can see there are the carbon nanotube based composites which have been commercialized in the market. Okay. But we need some more, and we expect some more new applications to come forward. Right, the second typical nanomaterial I like to talk about is the nanoclay. The difference between nanoclays and the carbon nanotubes is because nanoclays are soil-based materials, say, so they don't have any environmental problem, okay, as what you normally see for carbon nanotubes. They are based from the rocks and the soil extraction. Some of the clay structures we normally see, actually, we got the layered structure, platelet structures. So this is a typical chemical structures we normally have, but I'm not going to elaborate too much on the chemical structures. For the single layer of the clay structure, you normally have the thickness of the structure around about 1 nanometer. Or 0.93 nanometer roughly. So roughly about 1 nanometer for the thickness. If they could be well dispersed into the materials. These are the structures normally we could see from their composite point of view. That means either you get the aggregated particles due to the wind-void interactions of the particle to form immiscible polymer nanocomposite. So immiscible